Unmuted.
Okay, all right. I think it's a time for us to start our webinar. Very warm welcome to everybody, and I hope you all are doing good and are safe in your place right now. It's very tough time for everybody to even like the way the entire culture has changed to the webinar, and people are getting used to it. I'm really happy to see people joining in such a very large numbers. So I see right now the total participants we have is 98. So 98 registrations for this webinar. In fact, I was expecting somewhere around 120, but they may join in some time. So anyways, we'll start with the webinar. I think many of the people who are coming here, they are the repeat participants who have already joined our previous webinars. Can you just confirm me how many of you are have already joined our previous webinar and then joining back? If you can just give me raise hand in the chat box. Okay, Swami, I can see many people who are joining again. Yeah, okay. Okay, so I see like around 40% of the people who are participating in this webinar are the participants from my previous webinars, okay? And I'm really happy to have you back here so we can discuss more. And you know, you must be aware about what kind of learning path and what kind of knowledge sharing has been exchanged, right? So to start with today's topic, okay, today's topic is about statistics. Is it a very big deal in data science? This is the main topic of our discussion today. So let's just have a quick introduction, intro about myself. So as you must be knowing, I don't know if you've checked my profile, I'm the co-founder and the global head for academics and research, analytics and research for Basel Analytics. I'm also a co-founder at Business Toys. So I work closely with Business Toys for a lot of curriculum related, and then project related stuff, which I, do for mentoring students. And I love mentoring students along with my special love for data science and analytics. So I'll just quickly, take you through the reason why I'm conducting this webinar today. Okay. So this is a sequel of the webinar series which I am doing, and this webinar series is majorly to help people understand what is the proper learning path for people to adopt or get into the data science career. And if I can just recap, okay, I'll just take you through the learning path which I had discussed in my previous webinars, which you can check on our website. If you can open our website businesstoys.in and then go to the webinars section, all our previous webinars are listed in the list there, the recorded videos of the same webinar. And if you want to follow those webinars, you can just follow this webinar in the same list from bottom up. So the one which is last is the one which is first webinar is in the end, and the latest one you'll see on the top, right? So a very interesting learning path which I shared with you, which is very convenient, has given us access to enough number of people who are trying to move into data science and take up a data science career, right? So the first and the foremost thing that we need to know, that we need to have, is something called a very strong statistical foundation, which I already discussed with you before, right? The next is about the Python programming. The next is about the understanding about the machine learning concepts, right? The strong understanding about the machine learning concepts, and you being able to implement those machine learning algorithms by using the Python programming or any given programming language that you're comfortable with. So then it's something to deal with the SQL and NoSQL. So you need to have a very good understanding about databases. Okay, now when I say SQL is relational database, and then NoSQL, that also I'm planning to do a webinar on in future. I'm planning to do a webinar on SQL and NoSQL and how you should learn SQL and NoSQL, what all things a data scientist should be aware about when it comes to SQL and the NoSQL, right? The third thing is about the big data and Hadoop. Okay, so you should be having a little bit flavor, especially if you are an experienced person wanting to move into the data science. Then you should have a little bit idea about how the big data works and what are the tools and what are the new technologies which are there in the market, which industry is using right nowadays into big data, right? But apart from that, you should be also comfortable with some reporting tools, some visualization tools. Okay, and the market leaders are into the BI reporting tools is these are the two, that is Tableau and Power BI. Okay, after which we learn something called cloud, and then deployment of a particular AI based application into the cloud. Okay, and then we learn deep learning. You can shuffle up this deep learning before and then deployment later. That's up to you. And this is how you get a success into a data science career. Okay. Before you get a success, of course, there is a lot of effort that you have to put to build a project portfolio, to build a resume, and a lot of other things, right? So today's discussion, I'm only focusing on this part, that is having a strong statistics foundation. And how to have that strong statistics foundation is the point of our today's discussion, right? So to start with this, okay, I have... I'll tell you how statistics has evolved. Okay, how statistics has evolved, and there is one very famous meme around this, which I would like to share with you. If you can look at this, okay, many people have this kind of a little bit of misconception that people say that statistics was just plain statistics, and people rebranded it to artificial intelligence. Okay. To an extent, it is correct. To an extent, it is not. Okay, I don't completely agree with this, but still, if you see these four, pictures which are there, first there was plain statistics. Then people have put a frame to it. Then people are calling it as a machine learning. And then when they are telling it to the audience, they say this is artificial intelligence. Okay, no, this is not the exact thing. Okay, it shouldn't be confused with that, because machine learning has a lot of other things to do. Even deep learning has a lot of other things to do, which, like this machine learning and deep learning together constitute something called as artificial intelligence. And if you don't know what is the meaning of the statistics, you don't know what is the meaning of the machine learning, deep learning, these concepts, I think my previous webinar is that previous webinar about the data scientist and the data analyst, okay, is the best reference point for you to go through and understand what are the differences in machine learning, deep learning, AI, all these concepts. All right. Now, to start with, I want to take up one very interesting story. Okay. This story you might have listened before. You might have, I really don't know whether you have, have gone through this story, if you have heard about this story. It's a very important, story about it's a real story, in fact. Okay. And I would like to get it to your notice and then help you understand. Okay. Help you understand what are, what are the stories, what are the interesting stories around statistics, around data science, okay, and how data science has evolved, right? So the first and the foremost thing that I would like to tell you is, the story title is I Think You Are Pregnant. Okay, and now I'm not saying that you are pregnant or something. This is just a story title, and then what it says is, this is the real story of a teenage girl, okay, who got to know about her pregnancy from a grocery store manager whom she never knew in her life. Okay, so this is the real story. I hope you are very, very eager to know about the story. First of all, I would like to ask, how many of you are aware about this story? Can you just put me a message saying yes or no? If you are aware about the story, then yes. If not aware about the story, no. Can you just put it in the chat box quickly? If you are aware about the story, you just say yes. If you are not aware about the story, just say no. Okay, there are quite a few who are aware about the story. Okay, not aware about the story. Okay, there are a few people who are actually aware about the story. Okay, very good. So anyways, whether you're aware about or whether you're not aware about, I'll just go through and I'll tell you what is the key learning of this story. All right. Let us listen to the story first. Okay, so this young, angry teenage girl walked into a retail store in the US and shouted saying, I need to, meet the store manager right away. All right. So a store manager requested the girl to cool down and ask her what is the issue. Why is she shouting? Why is she so much confused? Why is she so much angry? Right. The girl said, I'm getting some advertisement brochures full of the products which are related to pregnancy through a courier company through a company. Okay. So this girl is receiving a lot of brochures about the products which are meant for the pregnant woman, right? So she says, like, did I tell you that I'm pregnant or interested in buying this product? She said, no. okay, right? And then why the hell are you sending such products or brushes to me, right? So she says, now my parents are doubting me. So this is her overall confusion, okay? Now what happens next is, the store manager requests her to, you know, wait for some time, wait for a minute, and says, you know, let me check my computer and, you know, check why and how you are getting this, you know, the brushes, right? So he went and she checked his computer and said, like, we are sorry, right? Because anyways, people will say that, you know, I'm sorry. But at the same time, the store manager said, ma'am, I think you are pregnant. Okay. So that is quite shocking, right? You know, you are going to a store, because you're getting some, you know, brushes, and you go ask the store manager, okay? And the store manager says, ma'am, you're pregnant, okay? How can this happen? Can you just give me a gist about this? Can you tell me how can this happen? Just message your answer to me in the chat box, okay? I want to know if the people who know what is their answer and people who don't know, what is their answer, okay? What do you think made the store manager say that the girl is pregnant? Might be based on the product she purchased, okay? Perhaps. Scanner. Okay. Okay, that is a good answer. Yeah. Oh, okay. So I'm getting so many answers. In fact, you know, I'm getting so many answers. I'm not able to read properly. But more or less, you have identified, you know, like the reason why that lady is getting the brushes and why, what made this store manager say that she is pregnant, right? So this is what is the power of statistics. This is what is the power of statistics. And can someone tell me, like, what is the role of statistics? Okay, what is the role of statistics in this particular use case? Okay, what is the role of statistics in this particular use case? What made, you know, like, how statistics is playing a role of identifying the customer's behavior? Can you just tell me one or two statistical tools which may be used, okay, in this particular use case? Again, I'm getting so many answers. Okay, it is very interesting to listen from you about your answers. Okay, let me just tell you what is the role. But the first of all, I would like to answer one question. How did the store manager came to know that the girl is pregnant? Okay, how did the store manager came to know that the girl is pregnant? Right? So here is my answer. So if you know, like, if you go to any retail outlet, let's say you go to, you know, Big Bazaar, or if you go to Walmart, if you go to, you know, the any big retail stores, okay, if you see the invoice copy which is given to you, on that invoice copy there will be something called as a customer ID, which is mentioned over there, right? So every customer is given a unique customer ID, right? Now, along with the customer ID, I hope you'll be knowing, you know, people will be given one loyalty card, okay? So this loyalty card is a source for people to collect a lot of information, okay? Like, for example, you have name, we have gender, we have, you know, marital status, which people ask, then the address of a person, the bank, you know, bank details, like credit card details, the purchase history. So many people said that, yes, there is a purchase history because of which you can come to know, you know, like what transactions were done before. The date and type of a purchase, the internet IP address, and then, you know, what type of website you visit, so on and so forth. So, you know, you get a lot of information. You give away a lot of information unknowingly, right? And this information could be a source of vital information, a source of, you know, heavy insights, which can be used for multiple purposes, right? So why do, you know, companies want to know if a girl is pregnant, you know, if a particular customer is pregnant? What is your response on this? Why people want to know if people are pregnant? Can Can someone tell me? Can you just message me your answer? Why people want to know if why the companies want to know the people are pregnant, if the people are pregnant, what is the reason behind they doing this analysis? Okay. Again, so many answers. Okay, yes. So some people are saying we can sell them some products. Some people are saying, okay. But sell products and how big is this market size? Can you estimate how much? Can you just tell me how much will be the average, total amount spent during the pregnancy on the pregnancy related products? On an average, one lady, okay, spending throughout the 9 months of pregnancy, how much on an average she spend? She or her family, how much do they spend? And you can tell me in terms of US dollars also, because there are a lot of foreign participants. You can tell me in terms of 10 rupees also, how much is the average spend throughout the pregnancy, especially on the products? If you can give me a number, like not 20%, 15%, no. Okay, some people are saying 5 or 6 lakhs. Some people are saying somewhere close to $5,000, $5,000, $8,000. Okay, so there are many people answering different answers. I'll tell you a median spend, which, a company, this same company did a research and they found out the median spend on the pregnancy, is somewhere around, in terms of dollars, is somewhere around $4,500. And in Indian rupees, if you have to just spend the same amount in India, if you have to spend the same amount in India, then it will be coming around 5 to 6 lakh, right? So now I'll tell you why. So new baby born in the family makes, family spend more. New baby in the family makes people spend more. And you will agree with me on this point, right? We don't think about, expecting parent don't think about the pricing, because, they are very happy. And when you are happy, you don't think about the pricing. So this is a high profit margin, segment for companies, right? They don't have to, specifically, they have to just identify customers and pitch them some products. Since people are happy, they buy everything and anything, right? Apart from that, it is very, very easy to pitch the product. You need not push this product. Because the products are available, if they feel that this product are good for their babies, they straight away buy such products, right? The model that, an entire, analysis could be done, where you can even estimate the date of, the date of delivery. If if you have taken the right data, you can even estimate the date of delivery. Now, why you want to know the date of delivery is because if you send some ads with baby diapers in the 9 month of pregnancy with some discount, people will not even think they'll jump and buy, right? Okay, so these are the different strategies which could be used. Okay, and I'll tell you that the main concepts which are linked to this in statistics is, one, there is something called correlation, which help you to understand the relationship between different variables, right? It's correlation is a statistical test which is used to understand the relationship between different variables. You can also, there are some machine learning techniques developed nowadays, especially something called unsupervised machine learning techniques. Okay, so these techniques are even more helpful. Okay, but even those techniques which are developed, they are heavily based on derived out of the statistics foundation, right? Okay, so these are, few of the tricks which I told you. So what is the learning from this story? Can you tell me what is the overall learning from this story? Can you just message me? What could be the learning from this story? What did you, what regarding statistics? What is in linkage with the statistics? What did you learn from this story? Okay. I'm getting again many answers. Okay. I'm getting many funny answers, in fact. Okay. So let me just tell you, what is the overall learning from this particular study. The first learning Statistics and hence data science is changing the way companies do business. Okay, and that is because you know that is the main reason why companies are hiring statisticians. Okay, and these statisticians' profiles are sometimes mapped to something called data analyst, and many a times as a data scientist also, right? And if you again want to know the difference between data analyst and data scientist, you can refer back to our website for my previous webinar where I've clearly explained the roles of data scientist and data analyst, right? And one more, learning from the story is the pregnancy prediction model that we just, saw in the previous case won't work for male customers. And that is just on a lighter note. Overall, I'll tell you, like, the main intent for me to tell you this story is you to understand people are doing a lot of business based on analysis of simple statistics, right? And I feel that every person on earth has a right to understand and infer, what data talks, because this is a new, the data is a, a new concept which is supposed to be, which is supposed to be taught to everybody, and everybody should know how to use data to derive insights. Even if you're running a small business, you should know how to use that particular data, because if you know now, every business is going digital, right? And when you are digital, you are generating a lot of data, right? And when you are generating a lot of data, you should know how to use that data to even optimize your business to the next level. Okay, you should take that particular data to take a lot of data-driven business decisions, right? Now, what are the main important concepts to be studied under statistics, in order to become a data scientist or a data analyst? Okay, what are the main important concepts? Okay, if you are aware about, if you have studied anywhere or if you have come across anywhere, can you just tell me, what are the important concepts that you are aware of? Just message me in the chat box. Okay, just message me in the chat box. What are the important concepts for a data scientist or a data analyst to study, okay, from statistics? Then I'll tell you my views on that. And I'll also tell you, what you should not study, what you should study, and, many more things which I take. Okay, someone is saying Tableau. Tableau is not, I'm saying only related to statistics. What statistics concepts you should study in order to become a data scientist or a, according to you? And I'll tell you, many people go wrong at this step. Okay, when they start their learning path, they don't understand in statistics what they should study, and that is the main reason for me to take this particular webinar. Okay, mode median, someone is saying yes, median z-score. Okay, regression, I'm getting again many answers. Okay, all right, I almost, my screen got flooded now. I cannot see this. I'll just tell you what are the main concept that you should study. Talking about the first thing, how you should start. Okay, the first and the most important thing under statistics is to study in under statistics is something called descriptive statistics. Okay, now descriptive statistics is the way to describe your data. I'll tell you, there are very few books or very few material or very few tutorials which are available on internet to actually learn descriptive statistics properly. Okay, so people do mistake of only learning theory or only looking at the tools without even looking at the theory. It should not be looked in that sense. You should learn the theoretical aspects also, and you should know how to apply the statistical tools in different use cases. Okay, so if you if you check our website, under our website there is one, if you open any of the data science course that we have, okay, in that I have properly structured what in descriptive statistics you should learn. So basically there are three main components of a descriptive statistics which you should basically understand. The first is the central tendency. Okay, the second one is something called dispersion, and the third one is something called shape. Okay, so under central tendency talks about that one number which is representing the entire population. the spread or the, you know, the dispersion talks about non-togetherness of the data, like how is the data spread around the mean, okay? And the third is the shape, which talks about the kurtosis and the skewness of the data. These concepts are something that you should be looking at, okay? So understand descriptive statistics in very, very detail. This is the main, you know, the main analysis that you do for your first step in understanding data, that is exploratory data analysis. In exploratory data analysis, you cannot do exploratory data analysis without understanding, without having a good understanding about descriptive statistics. Okay, so please, you know, first is you should study about descriptive statistics. Only then you will be able to understand anything else. Okay, now the next concept that comes to understudy is something called inferential statistics. Okay, and using inferential statistics, you do something called as a hypothesis testing, right? So inferential statistics is all about finding a right sample. Okay, it talks about how do you get a good sample which is representing the population. Okay, and there are various aspects to this. You can, you know, like do a lot of tests to come out with very, very insightful information, right? So what I'm saying is, you know, you should go into the details about what are the different theorems which are there under inferential statistics. I'll just name few. You should know, you know, the first and the foremost thing, you should know what is hypothesis, what is a sample, what are different sampling techniques available, okay? What is something called as confidence interval, okay? What is something called as critical value? What is type 1 error? What is type 2 error, okay? Then there are more concepts like, you know, central limit theorem. How do we use something called as a Z transformation? Okay, what is the, you know, what is the importance of Z transformation? Then, you know, what are these t-tests? Okay, how can we compare multiple means or multiple distributions? Okay, there are concepts of something called ANOVA, that is something called one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, you know, the multiple, you can have, you know, like multi-way ANOVA, okay? So that is something called a factor analysis in that, right? And then, you know, you have something called chi-square test, non-parametric test that we call them, right? Those tests are there. So you should know, understand, you know, the entire inferential statistics very, very well. The third thing that you should know is about the correlation and the causation. Okay, you should understand what are the different ways, you know, what is basically a correlation first and where it could be applied, how correlation is calculated, okay? Then there is something called as covariance also. What is the difference between correlation and covariance? Okay, how are these things linked? Okay, and what is the relationship between the descriptive statistics or how we use descriptive statistics in inferential statistics? What are the connections in these different concepts, right? So those things you should know, you know, once you master all this thing, then you should know how you link all these three above steps in learning something called as a regression. Because, you know, you'll be, whenever you're doing any hypothesis test, you'll be getting something called the p-value, the t-value, the confidence intervals, okay? How they are used in regression, okay? How do you define, you know, how do you, what is regression, first of all? You should know that, okay? These are all statistical concepts. And there are different types of regressions available. There is something called linear regression, multiple linear regression. We have logistic regression. Then there is something called polynomial regression. Then there is something called, you know, the ridge regression or the lasso regression. Okay, there are multiple types of regression which are available. There is also something called quantile regression. So there are multiple types of regression techniques which are available, which you should be aware about. Okay, so this puts a very, very strong foundation to your, you know, understanding about statistics. And the last concept that you should be learning, and you know, which is related to the statistics, is something called as a probability distribution. Okay, so probability distribution, there are different types of probability distributions, and there are different types of transformation techniques based on different, you know, like the shape of different distribution. Okay, so these transformation techniques, you should be, you know, very, very, you know, you should understand these transformation techniques very, very well. Okay, so these transformation techniques are used for normalizing the data. Okay, like there's something called log transformation, there is something called power transformation, exponential transformation. So these transformation techniques you should be aware of. And once you are thorough with these 5 points, okay, these 5 main headers, okay, to be learned under statistics, you will have a very, very good understanding of it, and you'll be able to apply it to a new concept. Okay, don't just learn these things and keep it for yourself. Okay, you should apply these things across different use cases. this use cases, I'll tell you from where you will find these use cases or how to find these use cases. You can research about it and you can, you know, straight away start practicing that. Okay. If you want to start off, kickstart your learning in data science, just do that. Okay. After you learn this concept, I'm also telling you about the references and all. Just see now. The next is I'm telling about this entire concept which I've shared with you. What are the three best books which I recommend you for learning statistics? The first and the foremost thing is something. There's a book called Naked Statistics. Okay, this book is written by Mr. Charles Wilner. Okay, so I want you to, you know, if you are starting with this, you should perhaps refer to this particular book. It's a wonderful book. Okay, wonderful book with very good explanation about and very good use cases, especially about statistics. Okay, the next is Practical Statistics for Data Scientists. I recommend this always. This is my favorite book. I tell you, this is the book which sometimes I refer for some concepts which I need a thorough understanding. Okay, I especially read this book, that is Practical Statistics for Data Scientists. And again, this is one which I recommend for the people who are just starting their data science learning. This is a book which even I give to the students whom are learning with us. So this book is called Statistics in Plain English. These three books, if you want, you can take a screenshot of this. Otherwise, you know, this video will be available on our YouTube channel. It will be available on our website also. You can check these books and the links, you know, if you want to buy these books, you can go and search it on Amazon, or there could be some PDF copies available shared by some good people across the internet. So you can search for them. You can download these books. Very, very good book. Okay. All these three books are very good. You should read them. Okay. So you can, you know, if you want to start off new, if you are very, very new, if you don't have any background knowledge about statistics or data science, if you're coming from non-technical background, never studied mathematics in your life, go for the third one. That's Statistics in Plain English. And if you are a person who is who have started your data science learning, you have, you know, somewhere read about this, something called, someone was talking about the mean, median, mode, something. Okay, if you've done some courses from some, you know, like platforms, open platforms which are there, and take up this book called Practical Statistics for Data Scientists. And if you have a good understanding about statistics, go for the first one. That is, Naked Statistics. Okay. So now these are the three important books for you to read. Okay. The next thing that I'm going to tell you is from where you will get data sets. Okay. Now these data sets links I'll be sharing with you in the you should check our YouTube channel. In the YouTube channel, the data set link will be there in the description. Okay, so these are the very, very good data sets which I have curated for people who are starting off new, and even for the intermediate people. The first one is Coursera data set. It's the open data set. You can download that data set. The second one is Industry Safety and Health Analytics. Okay, this is also a very good data set, but it's for the people who have already started data science learning, so you can take up this. The next two are very good again. Okay, you can take this up. The people who have started new also, they can also do this, in different levels of detail. And people who have expert, they can take it to the next level and they can start exploring this. Very, very good data sets. Okay, these are the four important data sets I'm telling you, which you can, you know, refer, which you can, you know, take up one by one and do it as your capstone projects or a small mini project for your learning sake, right? And then once you do this, you can mention these things in your resume, right? So the last question that I have for you is, after you learn statistics well, or if you know statistics well, okay, you should perhaps tell me, okay, after all that discussion, the debate which is there in the market right now is, do you feel that machine learning or artificial intelligence is the rebranded statistics? Okay, I won't give you this answer right now. I may take up this as a topic for our upcoming webinars in future, once you all have a good understanding about all these concepts of statistics, and then we can take this discussion to the next level, right? So very, very good topic to discuss. There's something called like this. We can always have a debate. We can argue. A lot of people say that statistics is rebranded, machine learning is rebranded statistics. I don't completely agree with it, but I'll get to tell you my thoughts about in what sense it integrates and what sense it doesn't. Okay. And perhaps then we can have a discussion around this. Now, in the last I would like to take any questions if you have relating to statistics, or you know what to do. I think compiled most of the things in this particular webinar. So if you want to ask me some specific questions, you can start asking me in the chat box. You can ask me anything that you have in your mind, so that it will be helpful for you. Okay, I'll take this for another around 5 minutes. Any questions for 5 minutes? Because a lot of people are asking me a lot of questions. So, okay, I've got a few questions. Okay, the questions which I've already answered during the webinar, I won't take them back. Any new questions, if you have, please ask me. The people who have joined in between, you can perhaps look at the webinar once again later, the recording of the webinar. Okay, if any specific questions are there. Okay, what is inferential statistics? Again, you know, Titi, I won't go into the details about inferential statistics. I'll tell you what is the idea. Okay, so inferential statistics is all about inferring about a particular sample. See, for example, if you want to do a market research, or if you want to launch a particular product, okay, so you cannot go and ask the opinion about, for example, if you want to know what is a good price of the product to be launched, okay. So you cannot go and ask everybody in the world what is a good price about that particular product, right? What you can do is you can do a small survey, okay? And then you can test whether the survey data that you have got, okay, is representing the population. And, you know, there are various tests which are there. You can use those tests, and then perhaps you can confirm, okay? You can confirm whether, you know, the price that you are recommending, the price which you are quoting for your product, will a lot of people buy that or not, okay? That is inferential statistics. It's more to do with the samples. Okay, and then trying to prove whether the sample that you have taken is representing the population or not. Okay, what are the career opportunities for biostatistician? Parvati, yes. So Parvati, I'll tell you, like, I can have a complete next level discussion in biostatistics with you, because one of my main key areas is something called as healthcare analytics. Okay, I work for one domain called healthcare analytics. I have, you know, like around 6 clients, which I, you know, closely work with them for helping them understanding a lot of clinical research data and the analysis of clinical research data and things like that. Okay, so I, like, again, in this particular, I can perhaps do this as a whole webinar in the upcoming you know, session somewhere. Okay, but if you want to specifically know anything from me, then you can, like, arrange. I can ask my team to arrange a call with you. I can help you with that. Okay, how is statistics useful for someone who is into marketing? Okay, that's a good question for me. See, I'll tell you, like, one is market research, second is price discovery. Okay, third is, you know, your market segmentation. Okay, so there are multiple concepts. It's not in one concept. And if you read that book called Statistics for Data Scientists, and one more book which I said, Naked Statistics, there are multiple use cases which are given with respect to this. Okay, so if you ask me, today we don't, you know, like, no businesses run on gut feeling based decision making. Okay, all businesses run on, you know, especially the digital businesses today, and even non-digital businesses today, they work on data-driven decision making. Okay, and perhaps that is the reason why you see very young people taking up the leadership positions in the company, because there is a lot of knowledge transfer which happens, you know, with to the people. Like, for example, if you just think of some big companies like Big Bazaar, okay, the CEO of Big Bazaar will never understand, like, you know, like, that since there are so many stores across world, across India, many people are walking into it, many people are going out from the, you know, like, from the Big Bazaar. There are various things that are purchased in Big Bazaar. So if they want to track it and bring it to one platform where they understand what is selling more, what kind of offers should be given, all such comes, you know, that those are the main concepts of statistics only which will be useful there. So every business person, every marketing professional should have a very, very strong understanding about the statistics in order, if you want to do a good business in today's world. Okay, I hope I have answered your questions for me. I have some more questions. Okay, how do I learn statistics if I need a mentor? Okay, so if you need a mentor, you can, you know, perhaps sign up with Business Stars. You can, they have very good mentors. Okay, and also you can if you want to learn on your own also, you can start reading books. You can do that, but that path is bit, you know, it's not impossible, because I'll tell you, I myself have self-learned a lot of things. Okay, so I don't you know, like, for me, learning things have become easier now because I know exactly how to learn things, right? But I say that, okay, if you are completely new to it, you may have a mentor, and mentor will guide you through, you know, teaching a few things and then perhaps telling your path, what to learn, what not to learn, right? Sir, thank you. Okay, there is any app or system which directly integrates primary market? There are a lot of databases, Siddharth. There are a lot of databases which are there, and these databases are purchased by big market research companies. Okay, so what happens is I'll tell you that this entire market research, there are multiple phases to it. There is one team, or there are some companies which are only into data collection. Okay, they build databases, and they build these databases for it to be used for market research companies. Let's say, for example, some big FMCG company want to do a market research, then they contact with these people who are building up these databases on a daily basis, okay, and then they take up these databases and then they do analysis. Okay, so there are a lot of companies. I cannot take those company names straight away to you, but yes, there are, and these databases are really expensive. Okay, you can take those up only if you have a big product launch supposed to be planned, or a big decision supposed to be done with respect to some good selling product, okay, or a new product launch. You can perhaps use those databases. Okay, I have some more. How can I register for the course? Okay, perhaps you can check our website and then you can click on the button. There, I think it's very easy enrollment process. You can sign up for it. There are some short-term programs also, like programs which are, like, for example, many people have a doubt whether they can do data science or they cannot do data science, especially statistics and all. There are two courses especially designed for such people. One is something called Python for data science, and one is something called business analytics. The business analytics is more of like, it's kind of starting point to a data science career. Okay, so it's a very short-term program designed for non-technical people wanting to get into data science. Even non-technical people can take up such courses. Okay, some more questions. Okay, that is, what is the difference between full stack data science and full stack data science and the data scientist certification program? Okay, so full stack data science is more to do with if you are an experienced professional wanting to get into data science, there are a lot of expectations from the market from you. Okay, and these expectations are into knowing new technologies. You should know a full stack of technologies in order to implement a particular data science solution, especially deployment part of it, especially the big data part, or maybe, you know, even the cloud integrations. Okay, such knowledge is very, very essential. Okay, and you know, those, that knowledge is integrated into that particular course called full stack data scientist. And if you are less than 3 years experience professional, you're almost a fresher. Okay, you're almost a fresher person who is getting into data science. So perhaps, you know, you can learn data scientist and full stack data science. They have to go for something called as a POC. POC is a proof of concept project. It's a very big project which is planned especially to take you to the next level of career transition. Okay, if you want to make for sure, you know, career transition, and if you're having minimum of 3 years of experience, you must go for full stack data science. Otherwise, you can easily go for the data scientist and you can still make a career transition. And yes, we help you to get a career transition in data science. We will, you know, we basically help assist you what should be your plan and preparing your resume, the interview preparation, all that. So that business wise do. Okay, how to become a data scientist? I think, Anuradha, you can check our previous webinar sessions. I have told the first webinar, the very first webinar, you can check, you know, like how to make a career transition to data science in times of COVID in 2020, right? So just have a look at that webinar, you'll have your answer. Okay, I think, guys, you know, I've taken most of your answers. There are some people still asking more questions. I'm so sorry, guys, because these are kind of repetitive questions, and I think the answer for those are our previous webinars, right? So please follow those previous webinar, the information which is shared over there. And still, if you have any questions, you can also tell me, you know, can suggest me what kind of webinars I can have in future. Already there are a lot of webinars planned. Okay, you can tell me what kind of topics which you would like me to discuss. Okay, and in my upcoming webinars, I'm also planning to start up, you know, a small kind of a mini course. Okay, it's a kind of a mini course. Well, you know, I'll tell you in 2 hours how some of the important things, most important things, how you can become a data scientist. And one small use case I saw during that particular course. So just be updated about this on our website. You keep checking our website, and then you will come to know about these updates. All right. So thank you so much, guys, for joining. I'm still seeing there are so many people joined. Like right now, there are 120 people who are participating still in the end. I'm really happy to see your response. I hope you like this. And there is a small request for you. There is a feedback, form which will get redirected to automatically once the webinar ends. Please give your valuable feedback so that we can improve on the webinars which we are doing in future. Thank you so much for joining, guys. I really loved your interaction and the participation. And yes, happy Teachers Day to everybody. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. And